We've spent an awful lot. A lot of time talking to him out there, and hope we can have a conversation tonight as well.
那么，因为呀，我们其实过去呢已经有很多对话的机会。我希望今天我们也能够本着这样的这个做法进行开诚布公的对话。
Maybe I should start more formally, although you and I have never been that formal with one another.
那可能呢，我应该正式一些，尽管我跟你从来都没有虚套。
Good evening to everyone here in the United States, and good morning to you, Mr. President, in Beijing.
我们在美国的同事们晚上好，习主席和中国的同事们早上好，你们在北京。
I'm happy we had found time to meet, and I look forward to a candid and forthright discussion, like all the discussions we've had thus far.
那我非常高兴我们找到这个时间进行这次的视频会晤。当然呢，我希望继续我们。 好像以前那样的坦诚直率的讨论。As
I've said before, it seems to me our responsibility as leaders of China and the United States to ensure that the competition between our countries does not veer into conflict, whether intended or unintended. Just simple, straightforward competition.
那么就好像以前呢，我也曾经说过的，其实呢，作为美中两国的领导人也应该做到的，就是我们的责任呢是确保竞争不会滑向冲突。 无论是有意的或者是无意的，那么也就是说，我们的竞争呢，应该是坦率直接的。
It seems to me we need to establish some common sense guardrails to be clear and honest where we disagree and work together where interests intersect, especially on vital global issues like climate change.
我们需要建立涉及竞争的合乎常理的护栏，清晰坦诚地对待我们之间的分歧。 在我们利益交汇的领域一道努力，特别是在诸如气候变化等重大的全球问题上。None
of this is a favor to either of our countries, what we do for one another, but it's just responsible world leadership, and you're a major world leader, and so is the United States.
这样做其实并不是给对方施舍什么恩惠，或者是卖什么人情，而是我们对世界的责任担当。作为两个大国。 美国的领导，和中国的领导都应该做到这一点。How
our bilateral relationship evolves seems to me to will have a profound impact not only on our countries but quite frankly the rest of the world.
因为我们之间两个大国之间的关系啊，不单呢是攸关于我们两个国家，也攸关于世界。We
have a responsibility to the world as well as to our people.
我们对。 我们的责任不单是对我们各自的两国的人民，也对于世界。It's
why we believe, and you and I have talked about this, all countries have to play by the same rules of the road, why the United States is always going to stand up for our interests and values and those of our allies and partners.
也就是为什么今天我们在对话的时候啊，我们呢也认识到，所有的这个国家呢都必须恪守同样的道路规则。 为什么美国永远捍卫我们的利益和价值观，捍卫我们的盟友和伙伴呢？
Past is prologue. I am sure that today we'll be discussing those areas where we have concerns, from human rights to economics to ensuring a free and open Indo-Pacific.
也因此呢，我们将讨论存在在我们之间的一些关切的领域，从人权到经济。
And I think it's very important, as I've told other world leaders when they ask about our relationship, is that we have always communicated with one another very honestly and candidly, and it's we never walk away wondering what the other man is thinking. And I think that's an important ingredient for this relationship, to be open and candid in terms of our relationship.
那么其实呢，我跟世界不同的领导呢，说到我们两国关系的时候呢，我都说到这一点，也就是说，非常重要的呢，就是对我们的之间的问题，关乎我们双边关系的问题，进行坦诚直接的沟通和讨论。我们从不回避问题，我们在进行对话之后呢，对于各自的想法都是非常清晰的。And
do, I think it's important we communicate honestly and directly. To one another about our priorities and our intentions.
对于我们的当务之急和意图呢，也因此我们有着非常直接、坦诚的对话。
I look forward to getting down to business and on the extensive and substantive agenda we have ahead of us, and I thank you very much.
因此呢，我期待着今天晚上跟您着手围绕着广泛而实质的议程展开讨论。我非常感谢您。
And thank you for your congratulatory call when I won the election. It was very gracious of you.
那么，同时呢，我要感谢您在我当选的时候给我发来的贺电。那的确是您非常客气。
Thank you.
感谢。
Thank you. Thank you.
感谢，感谢，感谢。
总统先生你好，向在座的你的同事们问好。今天啊，是我们第一次以视频的方式会晤，当然这个不如直接面对面，但也很不错啊，看到老朋友我感到很高兴。
Good to see you, Mr. President, and your colleagues. It's the first time for us to meet virtually. Although it's not as good as a face-to-face meeting, I'm very happy to see my old friend.
当前啊，中美发展都处在关键阶段。人类是一个地球村啊，我们面临着诸多的挑战。中美作为世界前两大经济体和联合国安理会的常任理事国，应该加强沟通和合作，既办好我们各自国内的事儿，又承担起应尽的国际责任，共同推进人类和平与发展的崇高事业。这是我们中美两国和世界各国人民的共同愿望，也是中美两国领导人的共同使命。
Right now, both China and the United States are at critical stages of development, and humanity lives in a global village, and we face multiple challenges together. As the world's two largest economies and permanent members of the UN Security Council, China and the United States need to increase communication and cooperation. We should each run our domestic affairs well,and at the same time, shoulder our share of international responsibilities and work together to advance the noble cause of world peace and development. This is the shared desire of the people of our two countries and around the world, and the joint mission of Chinese and American leaders.
推动中美各自发展，维护世界和平稳定的国际环境，包括刚才讲到的有效应对气变、新冠肺炎疫情在内的全球性挑战，都需要一个健康稳定的中美关系。中美应该相互尊重、和平共处、合作共赢。我愿同总统先生一道，形成共识，积极行动，引领中美关系向积极啊。关系积极的向前发展，这是造福两国人民的需要，也是国际社会的期待。
A sound and steady China-US relationship is required for advancing our two countries' respective development and for safeguarding a peaceful and stable international environment, including finding effective responses to global challenges such as climate change, which you referenced, and the COVID pandemic.China and the United States should respect each other, coexist in peace, and pursue win-win cooperation. I stand ready to work with you, Mr. President, to build consensus, take active steps, and move China-US relations forward in a positive direction. Doing so would advance the interests of our two peoples and meet the expectation of the international community.
下面我也愿意啊。这个与总统先生就全局性的问题啊，全面广泛的啊，开展交流。谢谢。
I now look forward to a wide-ranging and comprehensive discussion with you, Mr. President, on overarching issues. Thank you.
Thank you.
感谢。
记者们走了。
好，我们刚才看到的是中国国家主席习近平和美国总统拜登正在进行的视频峰会的一个开场的现场。美国总统拜登在开场发言时就提到了说，中美两国大国应的关系和责任不只是关系到中美两国的关系，也关系到了世界的关系。另外呢，习近平又强调说很高兴看到了老朋友，而中美呢正在处在发展的最关键的阶段，所以中美应该加强沟通，愿意在气候变化以及应对新冠疫情等全球性的挑战方面来共同加强探讨。